You are all in a tavern called Brewer's End, waiting for a violent blizzard to pass. All of you have been traveling to or from various places, each of you for your own unique reasons. Some of you might have been seeking fortune you have heard could be had elsewhere. Others might be running from trouble. Still others might be aimlessly wandering. But by whatever powers that govern your lives, all of you separately arrived here in this dark, lonely tavern that stands at the confluence of six roads and sits surrounded by the smell of urine, vomit, and yeast. You hope the blizzard will blow itself out quickly so you can continue your journey, but it seems to only continue to grow in intensity. You sit alone while the surly, dirty tavern keeper occasionally badgers you to order another of his foul-smelling drinks. All of you are bored and impatient for the storm to end, but it looks like it will carry on into the night. In a darkened corner of the room, furthest from the hearth, sits a heavily cloaked form whom the tavern keeper seems to avoid. Somehow, every time any of you look in the cloaked figure's direction, it seems to be staring at you. It never seems to move its gaze to anyone else. It only stares intently at you, and you alone. There is nothing at all happening elsewhere in the tavern, so you can't help but return your gaze to look in the direction of that staring, cloaked form. Its hooded face is in deep shadow, but its eyes gather and multiply the dim glow from the hearth and shine with bright green intensity. It holds a wooden pint mug in its right hand and gently wraps the knuckles of its left hand on the table slowly and rhythmically. Other than the howling and whistling wind buffeting the tavern, the tapping is the loudest sound. There is a tall, twisted maple staff propped against the wall next to the cloaked figure, and a long dagger in an ornate sheath at the figure's belt. On the floor next to the figure, there appears to be several bundles bound up with hempen rope. After the last of you has turned your gaze to stare fixedly at this figure, it stands and lowers the hood to reveal a lovely face with intense green eyes that shine in the firelight like glowing emeralds. Lime green scales blush her pale ivory cheekbones. She smiles and addresses all of you, but strangely, she seems to be talking to each of you alone to the exclusion of all others, and you can't move your attention away from her. "I called all of you here to me," the figure tells you simply in a steady, regal voice. "I'm called Carnesa Skydgazer. All of you need my help, even though only six of you will ultimately choose to accept it and join this adventure. The fates made this meeting impossible to avoid, and since I've learned that the fates will always have their way regardless of what I want, I've learned to allow the fates to guide my travels. Perhaps if all of you learn to stop struggling against the tides of fortune, you will find this meeting as well as your future endeavors profitable. If not, well, perhaps the fate will allow all of us to live a little longer anyway. Yet again, perhaps not. I say that six of you will join this adventure, for adventure it will be. That much the portents have promised. But let me also tell you what else the portents have promised. First, whether you choose to join this adventure or not, dark events will visit all of you in these last days of chaos. I have no reason to judge any of you for how you choose to spend those days, whether that's huddled with loved ones as the end approaches, or insensibly drunk and lying in your own waste. Both are reasonable actions when faced with the challenges beyond your ability to cope with them. But those of you who do choose to join, you bring to the adventure your singular abilities. If we're successful, we'll have your names writ in the stories and legends for all to hear about and admire. Secondly, all of you will experience great hardship and loss. For that, I am sorry, but It is what's foretold. I wish I could promise you differently, but the truth is more valuable, even if lies are more comforting. Next, one of you who joins this adventure will die before its conclusion. The portents hold in shadow who this person will be, so I can't tell that person to remain behind, even if the fates would be generous enough to allow them to do so. Lastly, whether we succeed or not, one of you will become a god. I was overwhelmed and excited when this fate was revealed to me, and almost refused to believe my own eyes. However, I cannot deny what the portents reveal when they do so with such crystal clarity. Among us right now sits a god, waiting for their glory to be revealed. Now this blizzard will stop blowing in a moment, at the moment I finish speaking, and you may choose that moment to slip away and continue to your destination. I will not attempt to hinder your going. I wish you well in your journeys, and may the peace of Narun guide all of our footsteps.